Did you know that you can use the hyperlink function to send emails directly from Excel? So in my opinion, this is going to be best for short standardized emails. And in this example, we're going to walk through how you can use the hyperlink function to send a short welcome email to our new hires. So let's get started. To send an email from Excel, you need a hyperlink. And one way to do this is by right-clicking wherever you want to insert your email hyperlink, click on Link, and then select Email Address. So unfortunately, this method is very manual. We can't link to any of the cells in our spreadsheet. So you would begin by typing the recipient's email. Then in the subject field, you would type the subject line of that email. And then if we want a friendlier name for the link, we can do so in this box. Then you would click OK, and this creates a link. So click on the link and it will create a new email message for you. And then you can just type whatever you want to include in the body of the message here. Let's close this. Before we start using the hyperlink function to send emails from Excel, it's a good idea to set up a few things. So what I have on my screen is just one example of how you can do this. So here I've noted the email addresses that we'll be sending to. I've used the concat function in the cells in column C to create a personalized subject line for our email. And then here I have a standard message for the body of this email. Now, the hyperlink function works by creating a shortcut to jump to another location. So this location could be a place in a workbook, another document, or somewhere on the internet, but it can also be used to send emails. So the basic hyperlink function has two arguments. The first is the link location. This is where you want to jump to after clicking on the link. And it's within this argument that we're going to be detailing the components of our email. And then you want to add a friendly name. So while this is optional, it's super helpful. And this is an option to assign an easier to read name to your link, something other than a convoluted URL, for example. So if you're watching this tutorial, you likely have a small business with employees. And if so, you should try the sponsor of this video, Connect Team. They're all about facilitating the employer-employee processes, including communications. So Connect Team is an app that employees have on their mobile phones. This means that they can access everything from anywhere they are. For example, you can use the Connect Team app for keeping up with your team's timekeeping, like scheduling, clocking in and out, and even payroll. They also make communications between managers and employees less chaotic. By using their Forms feature, you can achieve a better form of communication. You can use Forms for any need. You can use one of Connect Team's form templates, or if you need to, you can create your own. Your employees will then receive any form notifications directly onto their phone, and then you'll be able to monitor their form entries right away. Interact with employees directly when they make an entry, and if you need to, you can attach any file type to share with your employees, so whether it be PDF, spreadsheets, an image, or whatever else. So if you want a more robust option to manage communications with your employees, make sure you give Connect Team a try. Plus, if you have 10 users or less, it's free. And thank you, Connect Team, for sponsoring this video and supporting this channel. So before we start building our formula, let's go back for a moment to when we looked at the insert link wizard, the manual one that we looked at just a minute ago. In the text to display field, before we inserted a friendlier name, you may have noticed the lengthy entry that was being auto-populated as we typed the email address and then the subject. A few things are important here. Notice first that in the mail to before the email address, we're using a colon. So this is the same way that we have to write it in the hyperlink function. Then also when we moved on to the subject, a question mark was inserted. So this question mark is what separates the mail to field from the subject field. And here you'll notice that instead of a colon, it uses an equal sign. So that's something that we're going to need also. So, okay, keeping that in the back of our mind, let's start building this formula. So to create our formula, we'll start by typing the equal sign and hyperlink and open parentheses. Now, for the link location, this is where we have to detail all the components of the email. We're going to write in quotation marks, mail to, and using a colon like we saw in the wizard example, close the quotation mark. And because I want to reference the cell with the email address, I'm going to use an ampersand to join the two. And then I'm going to select the email address. Now I'm going to delete the reference to the table header and instead reference the cell address B4. Either way is going to work, but for the purpose of this tutorial, I think it'll be easier to follow using the cell reference. So now we'll insert another ampersand because we now need to connect the subject. So in quotation marks, like we saw before, we'll type quotation marks, question mark, right, subject, but this time we'll use an equal sign, we'll close the quotation mark, and again, we'll use an ampersand, and this time we're going to reference the subject line, so that'll be cell C4. We'll use an ampersand again, and now we need to add the body of the email. So in quotation marks, similarly to how we did the subject line, this time we're going to add another ampersand and we're going to type body. And like we did with the subject, we'll use an equal sign and close the quotation mark. And of course, we need to link the body. So we'll do another ampersand and select the cell that holds the body of the email that I want to send. I'm actually going to use the F4 shortcut to lock that because I don't want that reference to change as the formula gets copied down to the other cells. So then now I add a comma, and here we can insert a friendly name. I will write this in quotation marks since it's going to be text, and we'll use click to send email as the friendly link and press enter. And now this copies it down to the other cells in that column of the table. And FYI, if your data is not formatted as a table like I have here, if you're just using a data range, your formula isn't going to copy down to the other. So you'll just have to manually copy and paste that to any other cells. So now we can click any of these to send an email to that new associate. So before we wrap up, there are a couple of important points I want to note. So first, you may have noticed that here in the body, I have a few percent zero A's typed within the text of the body of this email. And this bit of code triggers line breaks. So using Alt-Enter isn't going to work here. If you're familiar with writing text on a website using HTML, this is kind of like that. So unless you specify a line break, all the text will run together. So for example, let's say I delete these two, and I have two because I prefer what it looks like with two line breaks instead of one. But let's say we delete this, and now we click send to email. Notice how now this line that used to be in its own line below it is now just typed next to Welcome to Company LLC. So the other thing, and let's actually undo this, add them back in. So the next thing I want to bring your attention to is this column labeled total characters. Now I did this because when we use the hyperlink function to send emails via Excel, we're limited to a certain number of characters in that email. And from my research, this number appears to vary by provider. But for me, just through trial and error, I discovered that the max value of the characters is 230. Now, this includes all the characters that combine the email, not just those in the body of the email, but also the characters that are in the email address and the subject lines, which is why my formula sums the results of the len function, which counts the number of characters in a cell for the subject line, the email address, and the body. So notice if, let's look at Emerson, since he has a pretty long email address. Okay, so let's say we type Emerson23. Notice how the link here changed from click to send email to a value error. So let's undo that. So you just want to experiment, see what works for you. Like I said, 230 is what works for me. If you do see a value error, you'll know that that might be what is triggering it. For more tutorials like this, please click on these links. Thanks.